Hello friends, welcome to my YouTube channel. This is being the very first video of the syllabus, so let's start with the syllabus of second semester English subject. Our syllabus is divided mainly into three parts. The first part is the theoretical aspect, thereafter second part is the classroom teaching contents, and followed by your grammar part. It's here. So let's come to the theoretical aspect. You know friends that in this theoretical aspect we will learn about the different approach, method and teaching techniques of English subject. Like any other subject, let it be science or mathematics, their teaching methods may be different than the English. So in our syllabus mainly three approach methods and techniques are given. The first one is the bilingual approach, the second is audio video method, and third is the language games. Next come to the classroom contents. In our classroom contents, the syllabus will be very easy. Let's see in this English in our daily life, that is normal and very low level sentences or words. There are some general greetings like good morning or good evening. Then comes to the introduction English alphabet with relevant names of animals, birds, flowers, fruit, vegetables, etc. You can see it's the introducing English alphabet. Means you have to teach your students of English alphabet. Okay. Then come to recitation of rhymes and poem with rhythm and intonation. From here to here you can see the syllabus is very easy, because whatever we will teach you in the first part, that is your theoretical aspect, various approach, method and technique, you have to, for keeping in mind these approach, method and technique, you have to teach your student this material which is given in the classroom teaching contents. Next come to your writing practice. Writing practice has been divided into here in two parts. The one is the penmanship, that is your handwriting. In penmanship or handwriting, you have to write your diary writing, like paragraph writing, essay writing, short story writing. But in our syllabus, it is mainly your letter and application writings. Thereafter comes your words or spellings. In D-LAD exams, normally it comes in the format like, if there are four spellings are given and three is wrong and one is correct, then they will ask, okay, find out the correct spellings of the words, or find out the right spelled word. The second way is, if the three spellings are right and one is wrong, then they will ask, find out the misspelled word. If sometimes they will ask that, they will give a word like knowledge or thumb or debt, and then they will ask, find out the silent letters. So these all are the examples of your words or spelling part. Next come to the grammar part. Friends, you know that grammar play is very important role in acquiring a language. Let it be in any language, science or grammar plays very important part. So we can say that grammar is the backbone of any language. The syllabus of the grammar part is like this: sentences, then its kinds, and parts of a sentence. Thereafter, your punctuation part. You know that if you're writing a paragraph and if you didn't put the proper sign of punctuation, that is your sign of interrogation, sign of exclamatories, and your full stop, colon and semicolon, then the meaning of the sentence may not only differ, but sometime it may be opposite also. We will have the very, very separate videos for every topic in detail. Then come to the determiners of noun, that is articles a, an, and the. Thereafter, noun, kinds and gender, determiner of noun, possessives, demonstrative, distributive, and determiners of number and qualities. After these nouns, it comes to the pronoun. Thereafter, adjective and degree of comparison. You know, adjective has 3 degrees. One is the positive, then comparative, and finally it's superlative. Thereafter comes the verb, the action verb. Again, we'll have a different categories of the verb, like your linking verb, main verb, helping verb, and many other verbs also. We'll have in details a separate video for that. Thereafter, it comes the transformation of sentence. Friends, we know that transforming of sentence is the changing of the words or structure of the sentence without changing its meaning. So in our syllabus, it is mainly 3 types, that is affirmative to negative sentence, assertive to interrogative sentence, then active to passive, and vice versa also, that is passive to active, your interrogative to assertive, then negative to affirmative. Then comes noun and numbers. Thereafter, it comes the articles, verbs, adjectives and its degree. Then at the end of, it's a lesson plan. When you go for TP, you have to prepare 20 lesson plans and 30 working days. So normally I have seen you guys that sometimes you copy from other one, or sometimes you manage some unfair means. You should avoid that. In our this video, I will tell you how to make a correct lesson plan. Friends, I'm planning to put daily 1 video on the English part, and it is not only help you out in the D-LIT exams, but it will help you out throughout all the exams. After all, doing the D-LIT is not your goal, but your goal is to become a teacher. So after qualifying your D-LIT, you will be applying for your TET and Super TET exams, and you have to not only qualify that exams, but you score good marks. And I will assure you that you will definitely score good marks in these exams if you regularly follow my video, or if you have any query, you can directly ask me. Then friends, come to the this slide. This slide is the exam pattern of PS level TET paper. Okay, you know that your TET exams contains 150 questions from 5 different parts. The first part is the child development and pedagogies, followed by language 1, that is Hindi. It is compulsory subject. Thereafter, it is a language 2. In language 2, you have to choose English or Sanskrit or Urdu.
out of these three you have to choose one.
Thereafter is your fourth part is the mathematics and followed by your EBS. So you can see guys that out of the five parts, each parts carry equal question numbers, that is 30, and equal marks, that is 30. That means every question got a equal marks, that is 1. So guys, please pay attention carefully. You can see from here to here, it is a language part. Either it is language 1 or language 2, either it is Hindi or English. If you want to not only qualify but also score good marks, you have to be prepare your all these five parts very carefully. It doesn't mean that if you are a BSc student your mathematics will be okay, that means you can qualify the exams. No, it is very difficult until unless you will prepare your syllabus according to the this patterns of the slide. Next come to the second slide, that is the syllabus of the TET UPS label. Here the difference is only that where in the PS1 it is the 5 part, in these UPS it is only 4 part. The fourth part carries 60 marks, 60 questions, 60 marks. If you are a science stream student, you have to attempt question from the science stream, that is your science and mathematics. And if you are a art subject student, you have to attempt question from the your social science subject. Rest part is the same as in this PS pattern, that is your child development and pedagogies, 30 question 30 marks. Language 1, that is Hindi, 30 question 30 marks, followed by your language 2. We have already described that you have to choose out of the three, you have to choose one. So again here you can see that language play very very important part while qualifying your exams. Now come to the last, that is very final part, that is the syllabus of your UPTET. And please, there is a big issue in between that, so listen very carefully, watch very carefully this video. The syllabus is like this. Your first part is of the syllabus is the unseen passage. In unseen passage, there may be one or two paragraph. You have to read paragraph once or twice, or depend on your comprehension power. Thereafter, answer the question given in the para. The next is the sentence, subject, predicate or kind of sentence. Thereafter, parts of speech, noun, pronoun, adverb, adjective, verb, preposition, conjunction, and next is the articles. Thereafter, punctuation, then word formation, active and passive voice, singular and plural, then followed by gender. So this is your syllabus of UPTET. Friends, now remind the previous slide of very first slide in which we have described the grammar part of DLET second sem exams. If you match it with the UPTET exams, you will find hardly any difference. Then why you guys are avoid the English in the part 3, that is your second language? I have seen that guys from the English stream, they take the Sanskrit in that language too. So here I have already emphasized you that you please pay attention on my videos very carefully. I'll not only cover the DLET syllabus, but I'll cover the UPTET syllabus also, and I'll promise you that you will not only qualify the exams, you will score a good marks. So having said that, being my very first videos, I have covered this syllabus. We'll come to meet you again with the next video very soon. So thank you very much. Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.